Hi, this is Kronos with a video on Peercoin paper wallets. Paper wallets are a great way to store cryptocurrencies for a long time while minimizing the risk that they'll be lost or stolen. They have some limitations though, and we'll cover some of those in this video. If you're looking for how to create and use paper wallets, I've put together a separate video walkthrough on that, and you can jump to it by clicking the link in the video description. In this video, we'll cover advantages and disadvantages of paper wallets, plus the best practices you should follow when using them. Let's get started. First, let's talk about some of the limitations of paper wallets. One paper wallet will store just one Peercoin address. It's recommended to use a separate address for each transaction so that someone you send Peercoins to can't link that back to other transactions you've made on the Peercoin blockchain. If you wanted to do this with paper wallets, you would need a lot of paper wallets and your life would get complicated quickly. Also, when you go to import paper wallets into your computer, you have to import the entire wallet. You can't import just a few of the Peercoins on your wallet. So paper wallets are better for large transactions and very rare ones rather than day-to-day transactions. Another limitation is that in-person transactions are not very possible with paper wallets. If you meet someone in person to do a transaction and you hand them a paper wallet, they don't know if you're keeping a copy of the private key that's written on that wallet separately somewhere at home or with a friend. So they don't know if you're really giving them the Peercoins. You could be secretly spending the Peercoins on that paper wallet at the same time that you're giving them. That means that paper wallets cannot really be used as a bill. You can't use a paper wallet like a 5 Peercoin bill, for example, as you're giving it to someone. They're not meant to be used as transactions, but rather as a way to store Peercoins for a long period of time. Now let's look at some of the advantages of paper wallets in doing just that. First, paper lasts a long time. A piece of paper will last maybe a couple hundred years. It will turn yellow and start to curl up, but you could read the QR code or read the private key off of that Peercoin paper for a long, long time. Compare that to a hard drive, which will last maybe 20, 30 years, or a CD, which wears out in 10 or 20 years, even a flash drive. A lot of people don't know this. A flash drive might last just 5 or 10 years, and it wears out quicker if you use it more often. I had a flash drive once. It only stored 128 megabytes. That tells you how old it was. I put it in my computer recently and it was blank. The problem is it wasn't supposed to be blank. It got so old, it forgot everything that was stored on it. You don't want that to happen to your Peercoins. By using a paper wallet, you put your Peercoins on a medium that's going to last longer than most digital options that are out there today. Another advantage is that it's a lot of fun to give something physical when you're giving Peercoins. I recently gave 10 Peercoins to a friend, and it was worth $15 at the time. It's since lost value, and we won't talk about that. But it was a lot of fun to write a message on the back of the wallet, wrap it up, and hand it to them. It's just not the same thing to write them an email and say, "Hey, what's your Peercoin address? I'd like to pay you some Peercoins." It's nice to make Peercoins physical, and paper wallets are a fun and cheap way to do that. You could also buy physical Peercoins with the private key stored inside of them, but that's a little bit more expensive. It's very easy to print out your own paper wallet and make something homemade, which is fun to give it as a gift. Now let's talk about some of the best practices you should follow when using Peercoin paper wallets. First, keep them away from cameras. If you're creating a video or doing video conferencing like I'm doing now, and you have your paper wallet in the background, say right here next to this interesting MacBook I have behind me. Well, if that were a Peercoin paper wallet and you could see the QR code on it, then anyone watching this video could spend the Peercoins without my knowledge. So you have to keep them very carefully away from cameras. This means don't keep a Peercoin paper wallet in your wallet, for example, because if you open up your wallet at the grocery store to, say, use your credit card to buy groceries, well, the security camera in the grocery store might see your QR code. Now, it's pretty far-fetched to say that someone's going to review the security tape and see the QR code and spend your Peercoins. But still, as a best practice, you should keep your Peercoin paper wallet far from cameras. Secondly, it's a good idea to encrypt your paper wallet with what's called BIP38 encryption. And that's a way that you can encrypt the private key so that if the paper wallet is stolen or seen by a camera, the receiver cannot spend the Peercoins unless they know the passphrase that was used to encrypt it. Again, if you're interested in how to use these tools, you can jump down check out the video description where you can see a link to a video I put together on exactly how to create paper wallets and how to use BIP38 encryption to encrypt your paper wallets. Well, that's everything I've got. There's not much to it. Like I said, jump over to the other video for how to exactly create a paper wallet. They're a lot of fun to play around with. Even if you have just a little bit of money in Peercoins, it's still fun to put some on a paper wallet and give to a friend. Try it out. Let me know if you have any questions. You can post in the video comments below the video or head over to the forums at peercointalk.org. We'd love to hear from you. I'm Kronos. Thanks for watching.